So your being cast in the show feels a little bit like the days in the 50s where somebody says, oh, they got discovered in a malt shop, and now, you know, there's a big star in Hollywood. So you were working on the show as a
boom operator, yeah. So I did sound. I was the guy with the stick, the microphone. But no, getting on the show, I tried to keep... When I was booming, I was booming. I wasn't trying to do anything else. There wasn't me trying to, like, throw in a headshot or anything like that. It was... So people didn't know. And when I don't think they knew. I don't think the show knew I was a boom op on their show until, like, recently. When Lenny mentioned it. Yeah. So I did you know, I was on a show called Hall and Catch Fire, which was also on AMC for 3 seasons of that. And it was just this, during that time, I guess I had auditioned for Walking Dead, and then Scott Gimple, he remembered that audition tape, and then he asked to, see me, and I was like, cool. So I sent some tapes in, and it all happened like in a day and a half, and then, yeah, auditioned on a Friday, Saturday, and then I was flying to Atlanta on Monday.
That's amazing. What a cool story.
Yeah.
And, I thought your story in particular, because the fans, I got a lot of shots of people in their cosplay, and there was a guy here with Ezekiel. Have you seen him? Stuff?
Oh, yeah.
And so I thought it just makes them feel like such a part of it. And
well,
so,
they are. Yeah. They really are. It's a lot of them. Sorry to interrupt.
No, please.
How the fans contribute is something where as a boom op, and it's not listed on my credits, but I've worked on dozens and dozens of shows, and everyone's worked hard. Like, there's some where they don't, but Walking Dead, cast, crew, everyone works super hard, like, the whole time. It starts with Andy Lincoln from the beginning. He sets the tone, really, of how hard everyone works. But a lot of it is because of how much the fans, how much it means to them. And so, there's shows where you can be an actor, but you're forgetting what you're doing it for. So you're maybe, parts of you are like self-serving, something that's inside, which is fine. There's nothing, another part just wants to tell a story. But then, especially for me these days, a big part of it is giving my best, because I know the fans care so much, And so when you see people dress up and you see people, cry, when meeting you, when you're at work, you're thinking, all right, I gotta do my best, because if they're not getting like my best work, then I'm letting them down. And so, it's huge, because that's what keeps all of us going at like hour 16 and 17. It's like, oh, I'm tired, but those people are expecting us, to do our part, and so we do. And yeah, that's why, yeah.
That's fantastic. Well, thank you so much for sharing your story with me today. I'll ask you one more thing.
Yeah.
Do you have a favorite moment from being on set?
My favorite moment I mean, this is a moment that comes to mind right now. It's not my story, even though I was there watching it happen. The kingdom was isolated. We were by ourselves, for a while, so we just interacted with ourselves. And when we first meet Rick, Daryl, and the whole group, Kari has this scene where, like, they're awaiting his answer on whether or not the kingdom will join. And Kari turns around, and he's supposed to give this speech, and he just stares at everybody. And he's been nailing his lines all the time. And he just looks at everyone, and he's like, yeah, I'm gonna go again. Yeah, and he was like, he just stared, because it just, like, what happens when you turn around, you're looking at Rick, Daryl, Rosita, Tara, like all these people, and you're like, oh, I'm on The Walking Dead, it was like a big moment. So I was cracking up, because I was thinking, man, I would flip out right now. So yeah, that was...
Well, it's another example of how, and I've said this to my son, he's come with me on a couple other cons and interviews, and I said, they're regular people, they just have extraordinary jobs, and unusual jobs. So it's nice to hear a story like that, because you think, at the core of it, at the end of the day, we're all just people.
We're all just people, and we're all fans.
We're all fans of the show.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you taking the time to chat with us today.
Thank you for
Thanks, Jack, for doing camera.